Laudetur Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ. Welcome to the Sunday live broadcast of the Regina Celi here in the Vatican, St. Peter's Square. As you know, after Easter we recite not the Angelus but the Regina Celi. It is the third Sunday of Easter, and Pope Francis will soon lead us in praying the Regina Celi. After, the Holy Father will impart his apostolic blessing, which extends to you wherever you are, in your home, in your car, or at work. My name is Father Paul Samasumo, and I will do my best to bring you the live commentary of the Angelus in English. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to welcome all of you joining us for this live broadcast on television or radio. Wherever you are in the world, welcome to our television viewers also, and our radio listeners, Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, EWTN, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, Atma Darshan TV, Luminous Radio, and Radio Maria PNG. We welcome those of you joining us through the various Vatican Media channels, such as the Vatican Media Live Events app or the Radio Vaticana app, Vatican News web portal, or the Vatican News English YouTube channel. And of course, not forgetting our shortwave listeners and those of you following us on the Vatican News Facebook live stream. You can always find more information about the Regina Celi of today, News of the Holy Father and the Church, on our website, vaticannews.va. This week, the Vatican sent greetings to Muslims as they started their holy month of Ramadan. The Pontifical Council for Interreligious Dialogue released the message addressed to all our Muslim brothers and sisters to show solidarity and friendship as they start the month of Ramadan. It is a period of fasting. And as you know, the Vatican has also paid tribute to Prince Philip in a homily during a remembrance mass for Prince Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh, and Queen Elizabeth's husband, one of the chief diplomats in the Vatican, Archbishop Paul Richard Gallagher, recalled Prince Philip's honorable and faithful service to the Queen, his country, and the world. So anytime we expect the Holy Father to appear at the study of his Angelus in the Apostolic Palace, and he will lead us into the Regina Celi. It is an overcast day, but rather pleasant and good to see once again people come into the square, St. Peter's Square. For a long time, the Pope had to present the Angelus from his library. And there is the Holy Father, Pope Francis.
Cari fratelli e sorelle.
Dear brothers and sisters.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
In questa terza domenica di Pasqua,
on this third Sunday of Easter, we return to Jerusalem in the cynagogue, as guided by the two disciples of Emmaus, who had listened with great emotion to Jesus' words along the way, and then they had recognized him in the breaking of the bread. Now in the cynagogue, the risen Lord presents himself in the midst of the group of disciples and guests, and he greets them, "Peace to you." But they are frightened and believe they are seeing a spirit. Thus says the Gospel. Then Jesus shows them his bodily wounds and says, "See my hands and my feet, the wounds. That is, I myself, handle me." And to convince them, he asks for food and eats it before their astonished eyes. There is something special. The Gospel says, because of their great joy, the apostles could not believe. What kind of joy was this that they could not believe their eyes? They were astonished. And an encounter with God always brings us astonished. It is another experience altogether. It's a joy which made them think, this cannot be possible. This is the awe that we experience before God. Do not forget this spirit. This gospel passage is characterized by three tangible verbs which reflect in a certain sense our individual and community life: looking, touching, and eating. Three actions that can give joy to a true encounter with the living Jesus. See my hands and my feet, Jesus says. Looking is not only seeing, it is more. It involves intention, will. For this reason, it is one of the verbs of love. A mother and father look at their child. Lovers look at each other. A good doctor looks at the patient carefully. Looking is a first step against indifference, against the temptation to turn the face before the difficulties and suffering of others. To look. I see and I look. The second verb is to touch. By inviting the disciples to touch him, to verify that he is not a spirit, Jesus indicates to them and to us that the relationship with him and with our brothers and sisters cannot remain at a distance. There is no Christianity from a distance. Christianity cannot be from just looking. We look and we come near. The good Samaritan did not limit himself to looking at the man whom he found half dead along the road. He bent down, treated his wounds. He touched him and loaded him on his mount and took him to the inn. And with Jesus is the same. To love him means we have to enter into communion with him. Loving him means a vital and tangible communion with him. And thus we come to the third verb, to eat, which clearly expresses our humanity in its most natural indigence, that is, our need to nourish ourselves in order to live. But eating, when we do it together among family with friends, also becomes an expression of love, of communion, of celebration. How often the Gospels present us Jesus who experiences this convivial dimension, even as the risen one with his disciples, to the point that the Eucharistic banquet has become the emblematic sign of the Christian community. Eating together the body of Christ. That is the central of our Christian lives. Brothers and sisters, this gospel passage tells us that Jesus is not a spirit, but a living person. When Jesus comes near to us, he fills us with joy. He leaves us in awe. We are astonished, and this always happens in the presence of God. Being Christian is not, first of all, a doctrine or a moral ideal. It is the living relationship with Him, with the risen Lord. We look at Him, we touch Him, we are nourished by Him and transformed by His love. We look at, touch, and nourish others as brothers and sisters. May the Virgin Mary help us to live this experience of grace. And now, the Regina Celi.
Resurrexit sic udixit, alleluia.
Ora pro nobis Deus, alleluia.
Gaude letare, Virgo Maria, alleluia.
Quia surrexit Dominus vere, alleluia.
Deus, qui per resurrezione fili tui Domini nostri Jesu Christi, mundum latificare dignatus est. Presta quaesumus, ut per eius, genitrice in Virgine Maria, perpetue capiamus gaudia vite. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidei vos defuntis, requiem aeternam dona ei Domine.
Et lux perpetua luce a teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
Lovely crowd there, responding to the prayer and acknowledging the presence of the Holy Father. Dear brothers and sisters,
ieri nell'abbazia di Casamari sono stati proclamati beati Simeone Cardon e cinque compagni martiri.
And the Holy Father, acknowledging the new saints that we have who were canonized yesterday.
Quando soldati francesi in ritirata da Napoli saccheggiarono chiese e monasteri. Questi miti discepoli di Cristo resistono.
And the Holy Father explaining their heroic works which led to their canonization.
Il loro esempio ci spinga.
And the Holy Father says that their example
capace anche
gives us that strength that pushes us, that should encourage us towards the Lord, and also that we too may serve our brothers and sisters. Actually, they are blessed, not saints. They are not canonized. They were beatified. And he asks for an applause for those new saints of the Church. Another sad thing. I'm following with the sadness some activities that are happening in Ukraine.
Del cessate il fuoco.
And I see that there have been some violations of the peace in the area. Please.
Auspico fortemente che si eviti l'aumento della tensione.
And the Holy Father asking that there will be a cessation from the tension and to make gestures for peace that will favor reconciliation and peace, making reference there to some tension building up near Ukraine and between Russia,
in cui versa quella popolazione alla quale esprimo la mia vicinanza.
He expresses his nearness.
Vi invito a pregare.
And as to pray for
Ave Maria,
the Hail Mary.
Grazie, il Signore è con te. Tu sei benedetta fra le donne e benedetto il frutto del tuo seno, Gesù. Santa Maria, Madre di Dio.
Prega per noi peccatori, adesso e nell'ora della nostra morte. Amen.
So praying for a lessening of tensions in the Ukraine area.
La giornata per l'Università Cattolica del Sacro Cuore.
Today is also a special day for celebrating the day of the University, Immaculate University. I'm sure you saw in the piazza there, in the square, the Catholic University of the Sacred Heart.
La sua missione educativa per aiutare i giovani ad essere protagonisti.
Referring now to the founder of this University of the Sacred Heart, which is in Rome.
I professori, gli studenti dell'Università Cattolica.
Praying also for the students and the professors of the university.
Un cordiale saluto a tutti voi.
A cordial salute, a cordial greeting to everyone.
Brasiliani, polacchi, spagnoli.
And making reference to the flags in the square.
Grazie a Dio possiamo ritrovarci di nuovo in.
We thank God that once more we are able to meet in the square for our usual. I missed the square. When I have to make the Angelus or the in the library, I miss being in front of the square, says the Holy Father. And he thanks everyone who is in the square today. And wishes everyone a lovely Sunday. Please do not forget to pray for me. Enjoy your lunch and arrivederci. The Holy Father, Father Regina Celi, of this Sunday, the third Sunday of Easter, and saying very much at the end there how he misses saying this Angelus or Regina Celi in front of the square, in the St. Peter's Square. And that is not the same when he has to do it in his apostolic library. The Holy Father also making an appeal for peace. There's been some build-up of tension in the Ukraine-Russian border there, making that there'll be some form of lessening of hostilities there. And that brings us to the end of the Angelus on the third Sunday of Easter. My name is Father Paul Samasumo, and on behalf of Vatican Media, thank you to all of you joining Pope Francis for this Regina Celi of the third Sunday of Easter. Thank you to our viewers and listeners of Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, EWTN Television, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, Atma Darshan TV, Luminous Radio, Radio Maria, PNG, Papua New Guinea. Thank you also to all our technicians here in the Vatican and other technicians at various television and radio stations across the world. As we said at the beginning of the broadcast, you can find out all the information about the Regina Celi of today, the news about the new blessed saints, the blessed that were beatified yesterday, and also news about the Holy Father and the Church all over the world. You can do this. You'll find this on vaticannews.va. That's our website. Do have a blessed day. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ.